down and out. When you're on the street, when evening falls so hard, I will comfort you. I'll take your palm. Oh, when darkness comes and pain is all around,
like a bridge over troubled water, I will lay me down. Like a bridge over troubled water, I will lay me down.
Good morning, ladies and gentlemen. On behalf of the Vietnam Veterans Memorial Fund, let me be the first to welcome you here today. Thank you for joining us for our 2021 In Memory Day ceremony. I am, as a lot of you know, Juliana Blaylock, Outreach Manager for the Vietnam Veterans Memorial Fund, that one that relentlessly emails you all the time. I love getting to meet everyone and finally put faces to all of the names and email addresses that I've communicated with for over a year now for this ceremony. VVMF is the nonprofit organization that built the wall in 1982 and is our privilege to host this ceremony each year. VVMF receives no federal funding, so we're only able to do this because of our generous supporters. We'd like to give a heartfelt thank you to our sponsors for today's ceremony, as well as our in-memory circle of friends for their generous support. Today we honor 361 individuals, your loved ones, who gave their all for their country. By the time this weekend is over, we'll have honored more than 5,100 veterans in our in-memory honor roll. While it has been more than 40 years since the war ended, the family members here with us today know all too well the impact of the Vietnam War on our nation's service members. We lose more and more veterans every day to Vietnam-related causes. It is my hope that you will walk away from today knowing that your loved one's service and sacrifice will forever be honored here. I would be remiss if I didn't say thank you for your patience as this ceremony had to be postponed due to the pandemic. At times we thought we'd never see this day, but we're so pleased to be here and have more than 1,000 people in attendance today. We thank you for traveling to be with us this weekend to pay tribute to your loved ones. I know we also have a lot of family and friends who couldn't be with us today. We are live on Facebook, so those families can be a part of the ceremony too. We will have volunteers read their honorees' names. Please know that we are doing our best on the pronunciations. We hope to make you all proud. I would like to take a moment to thank the VVMF staff and all the volunteers that make this day possible. We couldn't do it without your hard work. A special thank you to the West Point Alumni Glee Club who are giving of their time to be with us here today. They provided some music pre-ceremony, and we will hear from them again a little later. A few housekeeping notes before we begin. I would ask that everyone silence their cell phones for the duration of the ceremony. We know this can be a long ceremony, but we ask that everyone stay and remain seated until all the names are read. We want to give the same respect to the last name read as we do to the first name that is read. We'll have hand sanitizer at the ready before you come onto stage, and we ask that everyone please socially distance when you can. And lastly, if anyone at any time needs assistance during the ceremony, please reach out to a VVMF staff member or Yellow Hat volunteer. We are here to assist you and make this day special. It is now my pleasure to introduce our Master of Ceremonies, Captain Dennis Faraday, United States Navy, retired. Captain Faraday was commissioned in the Navy in 1969, Beginning in 1972, he flew F-4 Phantoms on 150 combat missions over North and South Vietnam, Laos, and Cambodia. He also participated in Linebacker 2. Captain Faraday retired in 2008 with 39 years of service as the last active duty Vietnam combat veteran of the Navy. He is a graduate of the Navy Fighter Weapons School, otherwise known as Top Gun. He has 2,000 hours in Navy fighter aircraft and 500 aircraft carrier arrested landings. His combat awards include 9 air medals, 2 AV commendation medals with Combat V, and the Vietnamese Cross of Gallantry. Please welcome Captain Faraday.
Gosh, I hope some of that stuff's true. Well, good morning, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome to our nation's capital. This is a beautiful day to honor those American patriots we are going to honor, your loved ones. Let me begin with a well-deserved thank you to the Vietnam Veterans Memorial Fund staff and to all who have worked together in support of this in-memory program. It is no small task to do what we're doing today and we also did yesterday. It's through their efforts that has made possible this extraordinary, moving, and immortal memorial to our Vietnam veterans. That is the backdrop for our ceremony today. For those who are able, I would kindly ask you please stand while the Joint Armed Forces Color Guard of the Military District of Washington presents the colors, and remain standing until the colors are retired. Ladies and gentlemen, we are privileged to have with us today the West Point Alumni Glee Club, again directed by Miss Nancy Riley. Thank you, Nancy. To sing our national anthem, I invite all veterans to hand salute the flag during the singing of the national anthem.
Oh, say can you see by the dawn's early light what so proudly we hailed at the twilight's last gleaming, whose broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight o'er the ramparts we watched were so gallantly streaming. And the rocket's red glare, the bombs bursting in air, gave proof through the night that our flag was still there. Oh, say,
us in the Pledge of Allegiance is Diane Parisi, wife of 2016 in memory honoree John Parisi.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America, and to the Republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Please welcome our chaplain that will lead us in the invocation today, Lieutenant Colonel James Foster, United States Army.
I invite you to just a moment of prayer, of silence, before we join together in prayer. Would you take a moment of silence with me? Almighty God, for more than 40 years, our nation has watched as our sons and daughters, who have given so much of their lives in a country called Vietnam, have done their best to heal from wounds that only you know and understand. I stand here today thankful that our grateful nation remembers their sacrifices. So we honor them today, and we strive to come alongside and bless their family members and loved ones. Give us grace and wisdom to know how and where to respond to those in need. Teach us to love one another and use the same measure of devotion to those on our left and right that was modeled by our heroes of service so many years ago. Bring continued healing, love, and forgiveness into the hearts of men. And I ask that you bless those who've gathered here today, and God bless our nation. In your name I pray, amen.
The West Point Alumni Glee Club was established in the fall of 2007 to carry the rich legacy of singing patriotic and inspirational music, a significant element of the warrior spirit. Membership is limited to West Pointers who enjoy singing and believe in the importance of traditional music in their continued service to the nation. Members average almost 20 years of active duty service, with more than 75% being combat veterans. Their goal is to spread the love of music among warriors and to honor and memorialize veterans, servicemen and women, and their families. Ladies and gentlemen, I present the West Point Alumni Glee Club singing "The Mansions of the Lord."
Stand and guard, though the angels.
Thank you. That was beautiful. And by the way, Army has a hell of a football team this year, and Navy doesn't. It's indeed a... messed up my line again. It is indeed a tremendous honor to stand before you today. This morning we come together to remember our fallen comrades. We honor those service members who, as Abraham Lincoln said, gave their last full measure of devotion for this country. As we gather today to honor our patriots, your loved ones, our Vietnam veterans, whatever the disagreements over policy that prevailed during the war in Vietnam, there can never be and must never be any disagreement as to how we treat and commemorate those who served with honor and dignity in that war. They were drawn to a cause, a patriot's cause, much larger than themselves individually. As Ronald Reagan once put it, the veterans of Vietnam were, and I quote, what we can only aspire to be, giving, unselfish, the epitome of human love to lay down one's life so that others may live. To my generation of veterans, this place is hallowed ground, sacred to our fallen brothers and sisters. This wall is not only a place, but it's also a time that we can return to and heal, share memories of each other and our experiences in Vietnam. We come to this place, this wall, to pay homage to the heroes of a war long over that continues to take Americans from our generation. Each of the service members we will honor here today wore with pride and honor the uniform which I like to call the cloth of our country. A significant number of these patriots were buried in this cloth of America. When the country called, they knew it was their turn to stand up for America, just as their fathers and grandfathers did in World War, heroically, I might add, in World War I, World War II, and the Korean War. Throughout their lives, these soldiers, sailors, Marines, and airmen were proud of their service to the United States and knew their sacrifices were cherished in the hearts of their fellow countrymen. Vietnam service is once more universally recognized as a true badge of pride and courage. Along with their families, they are truly the long-suffering, unsung heroes of the Vietnam War. They bore their wounds with honor and dignity. Their ultimate sacrifices are the same as the 58,281 names on the memorial. We salute all who serve with them, and we stand with the families who love them today. Thank you. I now invite the family and friends of those previously inducted into the Memory Honor Roll to come up and read their loved ones' names. Again, only past participants.
Honoree Larry James Kingsbury, U.S. Army, Vietnam, 71-72. Loving dad, husband, Grampy, we love and miss you still.
Staff Sergeant John F. Parisi, United States Marine Corps, 1965 to 1971, Vietnam, 1966 to 1967. I planned on spending the rest of my life with you. Thank you for spending the rest of your life with me.
honor of my husband, Edward Frederick Mishazik, retired United States Marine Corps Master Gunnery Sergeant, Vietnam 65 to 67. Semper Fi.
I'm here to honor my husband, Michael Dale Anderson. He was a Vietnam vet. He served in Vietnam in 1970, January to December. He came out in E5, and we were married for 50 years whenever he passed away in 2017.
My father, Robert Patrick Kapczynski, 173rd Airborne Brigade.
My dad, Master Sergeant George Berry, retired U.S. Army.
In loving memory of Lance Corporal Tony Michael Patterson, USMC 2019 honoree, Vietnam 1969 to 70 and 1970 to 71.
William LaRusso, friend, brother in arms, member of a veterans group that meets together for years. He died, he was an E5, and he passed from bile duct cancer. Thank you.
Steve Stoddard, United States Army, Vietnam, 1969-70.
John Carlton Burr, U.S. Marines, the most adventurous, protective big brother a girl could ever wish for, inductee 2012.
Memory of my father, Staff Sergeant, 4th Battalion, 31st Infantry, William Arthur McManus, Purple Heart recipient.
My beloved husband, number one, John Carlin Hollander, Vietnam 67-68, and recently my beloved husband, number two, Paul Crawford Stancliffe, and fellow volunteer, Vietnam 1967.
My father, Jim Henderson, U.S. Air Force.
On behalf of the families of the In Memory Circle of Friends who cannot be here with us today, I will be reading the names of their honorees. George Adams, James Ellis Albertson, Timothy E. Cannon, Michael James Apollonia, Gary Wayne Atchison, Ronald James Brown, Ronald Bruce Brown, William Dennis Cannon, Clark A. Chamberlain, Daniel Drummond, Marcellus Eugene Klein, Eugene Davis, Charles Diburn Davis, David Lee DeCourt, Arthur Michael Demopoulos, Herman Downs, Eugene Duncan, Rufus Lee Edwards, Edward J. Feely, Craig Dwight Ford, David Scott Foster, James Francis Welter, Keith Galloway, Bruce M. Gassler, Otis Herman Glenn Jr., Leon K. Greiner, Frank Thomas Gunther, Donald Dwight Higgins, Jerome M. Hall, Gerald William Heidi, Gary Lynn Hendry, John Leslie Hepner, Bruce Andrew Hilt, Dennis Huey, James D. Fisher, Wilmer Harold Eisenhower, Kurt Lewis Johnson, James Joseph Krause, Donald R. Joyner, David Keith Fryer, Dennis A. Kelly, Ronald Kirkland Kingsley, J. Brent Lang, Jimmy Dale Lindemann, Robert Lopez Orta, Joseph Lewis Barthel, Charles Joseph Louvre. I'm sorry, I'm going to say that again. Chuck Louvrier. Harry Richard Boring. John D. Marlowe. John J. Martin II. Danny Carl Martin. Jack Allen Folsom Sr. Joseph George Felke. Ronald McCarty. Patrick L. McClure. Patrick E. McDaniel. Harold R. McDaniel, Jr. Terry Dean McPheeters. Louis Jean Miller. Clifford Miyashiro. Gregory Raymond Mullen. Dale William Musoff. Kenneth Ostenick. Richard J. Osborne. Ken Osterbahn. James O. Otterness. Lou Millen Palmerly. Vernon Caldwell Park. Herbert Albert Perrone. Donald Paul Pfeiffer. Peter Philip Philhauer. Olaf James Krajek. John Stephen Price. Ralph Emerson Reinhardt. James E. Resch. Arthur Reynolds Jr. John L. Riggle. Norbert R. Rosenbaum. Norman Jean Rosendahl. Joseph Ruthberg. Kenneth E. Satterfield. Max Burton Scheider. Joel Stewart Schulman. Lauren Patrick Shea. Terry Lee Simmons. Michael J. Sokola. Lyle Jean Sustad. Robert E. Smith. Major Robert P. Teal Sr. James Edward Thomas. Billy Marshall Thomas. William Michael Tigner. Michael Patrick Valerie. Billy Ray Ward. Frank Weinsheimer. John Peter Alcama. Patrick L. Wright. Robert M. Wright. Terry R. Wright. Ronald Joseph Seild.
Now I would like to introduce our keynote speaker. Jim Knotts is the President and Chief Executive Officer of the Vietnam Veterans Memorial Fund. He is an Air Force veteran of the Persian Gulf War and a graduate of the United States Air Force Academy. During his almost 10 years in the Air Force, his career spanned service in the Persian Gulf War at the headquarters of U.S. Southern Command and at the Pentagon in the offices of the Secretary of Defense Staff.
Well, welcome everyone. I know there have been a lot of delays in this event, this day finally arriving, so let's celebrate. We finally made it. And just as we get to the main part of our ceremony, the cloud cover is coming in, so it's perfect. On behalf of the Vietnam Veterans Memorial Fund, we're pleased to host today's In Memory ceremony and welcome you all to our nation's capital. Today, in the shadow of the wall, we honor the service and sacrifice of the men and women who served in the Vietnam War and have since died. The Vietnam War became unpopular at home. Yet nearly 3 million men and women served in country during that time. They served for lots of reasons. You know, maybe a legal obligation because they were drafted, or a sense of duty to serve their nation when they were called upon, or even so that others did not have to serve. Thankfully, most returned home. However, as you family members know, coming home from Vietnam was just the beginning of a whole new fight for so many of our Vietnam veterans. Many never fully recovered emotionally or physically from their experiences of war. That's really why the In Memory program exists, because only a fraction of the casualties actually occurred on the battlefield. Many more carried their wounds back and suffered long after the actual fighting ended. As these service members pass, it is our duty and our solemn promise to welcome them home to this place that our nation has set aside for Vietnam veterans. While they may not meet the Department of Defense requirements to be added to the wall, they certainly are worthy of joining their brothers and sisters in this place of honor and remembrance. For many of the family members here, today this ceremony is a bit bittersweet. Your losses are still new. While that pain lingers, you're proud of your Vietnam veteran. I know you are because I see it in your faces. And you're happy to see them finally receive the recognition that they deserve. Absolutely. The In Memory program has brought you all together here today. So look around, you are not alone. We want you to know that there are others who have shared your similar experiences in caring for, standing by your Vietnam veterans, and also suffering the loss as they've passed away. I offer you this thought, which I hope will bring you some comfort. Our Vietnam veterans took upon themselves the commitment to never allow our country to send another generation of Americans into harm's way again without the proper respect and support that they deserve. That is part of their legacy. And the next time you hear someone say, "Thank you for your service," to someone wearing a uniform, you can take comfort in knowing that that thanks also is being extended to your loved one. More than 4,700 service members are already a part of the In Memory Honor Roll as of our ceremony yesterday. And today, we add another 361. My challenge to each of you is to go home and find another family who has lost their Vietnam veteran and tell them about this program so that we can also honor their loved ones. Together, we'll make sure that their sacrifices and those of their families will never be forgotten. For as long as visitors come to this place to learn, your loved ones will be remembered. Now, what the families and friends of our 2021 honorees are about to do has become a tradition here at the wall, and that is the reading of the names. At this time, we'll begin to read the names of this year's In Memory honorees, and I ask you to hold your applause until the names of all of our honorees are read today. Please remain in your seats until your row is released by an usher. Once you've read your honoree's name, please return to your seats. If any of you are willing and interested in helping us read the names of those who do not have family members here today, after you've read your loved one's name, then you can go to the tent and they'll tell you how you can help us with that part of the ceremony today. As we assemble, you'll hear a recording of a special song that recognizes those who served in Vietnam called "The Unsung Heroes" by Chuck Price. Chuck performed it at our ceremonies for many years until his death. Ladies and gentlemen, The Unsung Heroes.
It's time to sing a song for the unsung heroes. Let's all stand up tall and sing it loud. Let's all sing a song for the unsung heroes. And when we're through, there will be no doubt. Sing it for the ones that didn't make it. Sing it for the ones who live to tell. Sing it for the doctors and the nurses and the corpsmen who witnessed living hell. We'll sing it for the ones who flew the chopper, Sing it for the ones who flew the jets. Let's make sure that we all remember, 'cause the price they paid is too much to forget. So let's all sing a song for the unsung heroes. Let's all stand up tall and sing it loud. Let's all sing a song for the unsung heroes. And when we're through, there will be no doubt. Let's all sing a song for the unsung heroes. Let's all
Ladies and gentlemen, it is now my honor to begin our reading of the names for our 2021 honorees. On behalf of the family of Leonard E. Clark, Jr., United States Air Force.
On behalf of the family of Frank L. Glow, United States Army.
On behalf of the family of Norman Skipper Ness, United States Army.
On behalf of the family for William James Goldman, U.S. Army, Vietnam 66 to 68. Welcome home, brother.
On behalf of the family of Terry Vaughn Wilson, U.S. Marine Corps.
On behalf of the family of Joseph Edward Gaffney, U.S. Army, Vietnam service 1967 to 1969.
On behalf of his family, I honor Ronnie Williams.
On behalf of the family of Jesse Ewell Cantrell, U.S. Army, passed in 2010, Vietnam 1965.
On behalf of the family of Charles Frederick Wing, Marine Corps.
On behalf of the family of Mario Galvin, United States Army.
On behalf of the family of Norman Charles Megahan, Air Force, Vietnam 1966 to 67.
On behalf of the family of Talma Joe Fowler, serving in Vietnam from 1966 to 1967. And he was in the United States Army.
On behalf of the family of Jerry Martin O'Neill, U.S. Army, Vietnam 1970 to 1971.
On behalf of the family of Richard Lauren Frost, United States Army, served in Vietnam in 1972.
On behalf of the family of Frederick W. Temple, United States Navy, Vietnam service 1968 to 1969.
In memory of John Merwin Beeler, U.S. Army.
On behalf of the family, Jimmy John McGraw, U.S. Army, served two tours in Vietnam.
On behalf of the family, Richard Allen Clark, Marine Corps.
On behalf of the family of Paul L. Stoudemeyer, U.S. Army, Vietnam, 1968 to 1970.
Our father, John Allen Balkin, U.S. Army, 1968-1970.
On behalf of the family of Charles William Stephan, United States Air Force, in Vietnam, 1967 through 1969. Welcome home, brother.
My husband, Robert M. Griffiths, Army, Vietnam, 1966-67. It's an honor to represent the family of Lance E. Schultes, USA Navy.
Our dad, Dominic Gabriel, United States Marine Corps.
On behalf of his family, Ronald Leon Winiger, Army.
On behalf of the family, William Baker Carlton, U.S. Army. Hoorah.
Our dad, John J. Finley, and their pop, Vietnam, United States Army. Love you, Pop.
Lieutenant Wayne Crow served 1969 to 1970, U.S. Army, bronze and silver medal recipient.
In honor of my father and grandfather to my daughter, Dwight T. Powers, U.S. Marine Corps, 1967 to 1969, we love and miss you so much.
In memory of my husband, a loving father and grandfather,
and my dad, Patrick Dale Beaver, Sr., U.S. Navy.
My dad,
my grandpa,
U.S. Army, two tours in Vietnam, 1967 to 68, 1970 to 71. Chaplain Cecil Lewis.
Our father and proud grandfather, Joseph J. Pavlik, Jr., U.S. Army.
In loving memory of my husband,
my papa, Stan Gallus,
Corporal U.S. Marine Corps, Vietnam, 66-67, we love you, we miss you, we honor you. Welcome home.
On behalf of the family of James David Collette, U.S. Marine Corps.
Loving husband, father and grandfather, Daniel Paul Ponick, U.S. Army, 1963-65.
On behalf of Howard Atwater, my brother, and the Atwater family, Vietnam vet.
We're here to honor my father, grandfather, brother, loving husband and a great friend, Carlos Jose Uresti, Vietnam, 69-71, Bronze Star recipient.
Captain Jerry Lee Floyd, U.S. Army, Vietnam, 1970.
A husband, father, grandfather.
On behalf of the family of Howard Kent Stutz, our father, U.S. Navy, we love you.
My father, Robert Tolwitz, U.S. Army Corps of Engineers, Vietnam, 1968-69.
My father, Captain Stephen Michael Wistrand, United States Marine Corps Combat Medical Evac Pilot.
Husband, father, grandfather, Floyd Shorty Allen Hall.
For my dad, Lowell Gilmore, U.S. Marines.
The family honors the memory of Carl D. Krabs, Vietnam, 66-68, U.S. Army.
In honor of my best big brother ever, Paul Jerome Melnick, and on behalf of his wife and kids who couldn't be here today, love you.
On behalf of his loved ones, we honor Ronald David Krebs, U.S. Army.
Honoree,
Robert Joseph Hanishek.
Husband, father, grandfather, U.S. Navy, CB, 1968-69.
Honoring my husband, Sam Molsky, U.S. Army, Vietnam, 1967-1968, also father, grandfather.
In loving memory of proud father, grandfather, husband, Mason, and Army, 66-68, Vietnam, Wayne Douglas Foster. We're proud of the fight, Dad. We love you.
In memory of Donald F. Crowell, United States Army.
In honor of my grandfather, Sergeant Corsino Toro Jr., United States Army, 1967, 1969. We love and miss you, Grandpa.
In honor of my daddy, our hero, Dennis Leroy Christian.
My brother's last words, though scratched on a piece of paper, were, "I'm paying the price for your freedom," and that holds true for everyone being honored here today. Thank you and welcome home.
On behalf of the family, Billy Leland Seagraves, United States Marine Corps, Vietnam, 1969.
In memory of my husband, Daniel Bernard Stachurski, who's a loving father and grandfather as well, served in Vietnam, 1968 to 1970, U.S. Army.
On behalf of the family of Sanford Maple Mullis, United States Army, Vietnam, 1968 to 1973.
In memory of my husband and their father, Barry Allen Gallus, served in Vietnam from 68 to 69, U.S. Army.
On behalf of the family of Edward Earl Thompson, U.S. Army, Vietnam, 1970.
On behalf of the family, John Henry Culbertson, U.S. Army.
In loving memory of my husband and soulmate of 45 years, J.B. Meacham.
My father.
Loving husband, father, Poppy, brother, uncle, faithful servant of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, Vietnam, 1969 to 1973, United States Navy.
Our hero.
On behalf of the family, Robert A. Feisler, U.S. Army, hoorah.
In loving memory of my father, Earl Lee Taylor, U.S. Army retired, we love and miss you. Dad, love you.
Our father, Ricardo Lechleiter Reyes, also grandfather, Pop-Pop Rick, teacher.
Sergeant, United States Marine Corps, served in Vietnam, 68-70, passed due to complications of Agent Orange exposure. Miss you, Dad.
In memory of our children's grandfather, our father.
My husband and our hero, Frank Joseph Gubala, U.S. Army.
It's an honor to represent the family of William Kelton Carey, USA Navy.
In honor of Samuel King Jones, Vietnam, 1963 to 1967, United States Air Force, you'll be missed.
In honor of Patrick Ryan Farrell, U.S. Army.
In honor of my dad, Barry Miller, U.S. Army, 1966 to 69.
My husband, Robert Bruno, Military Police, U.S. Army. We miss you.
My great uncle, Harold Barefoot, Army.
On behalf of the family of Peter Adams Fellman, United States Army, service in Vietnam, 1968 and 1969. Well done, soldier.
My husband, father and grandfather, David Howard Coons, 1969 to 1973, U.S. Navy.
On behalf of the family of Richard Frederick Fick, Jr., U.S. Air Force, Vietnam, 1971 to 1975.
On behalf of the family of Terry Lee Tiffany, United States Navy, Vietnam, 1968 to 1972.
In honor of the family of Stan Ferguson, U.S. Navy, Vietnam, 1968 to 1970.
On behalf of his family, Michael Allen Nash, Navy.
In loving memory of my husband, a father, and a grandfather, Richard Charles Laux, U.S. Navy.
In honor of my husband of 46 years and Nick's father, Staff Sergeant David B. Waltick,
U.S. Army, Vietnam, 1965 to 1968. Welcome home, soldier. Rest in peace.
In honor of Patrick Michael Farrell, the United States Air Force.
In loving memory of my husband, Arthur Richard Flanagan, Dad, Pa, U.S. Army, Vietnam, 1968-1969.
In memory of my husband.
And our brother.
Our brother. Thomas Frank Ferrer, U.S. Marine Corps, Staff Sergeant, 66 to 68, past 1980. We love you.
Miss you every day, Tom.
In memory of our dad, Fred Savarni, United States Army, we miss you.
On behalf of loved ones, we honor Peter James Hundahl, U.S. Army.
Sergeant John Daniel Guilford of Defiance, Ohio.
Loving husband, father, brother, and our grandfather. Served in the United States Army, the 173rd Airborne from 1969 to 1970.
In memory of our father, Charles George Sharkey, U.S. Air Force Air Rescue, Vietnam, 66 to 68. Loving father, husband, and grandfather.
In loving memory of my father, Gerald Clayton Hune Jr., a husband, father, brother, grandfather, great-grandfather, and uncle, U.S. Navy, Corpsman for the Marines, Vietnam, 67 to 68.
In honor of our papa, Mark Douglas Hutchinson.
U.S. Army, 1969 to 1970. We love you, papa.
In honor of our father, loving husband, and grandfather, Frank Charles Harrison, Jr.
U.S. Army, Vietnam, 1966 to 67.
Thank you.
In memory of Leonard Densmore, Jr., United States Army.
In honor of my husband
and my father and grandfather,
Glenn Arthur Vermette, Jr., Army.
Thank you.
In honor of my father, Jeffrey Carl Knutson, U.S. Navy, served 72 to 74, loving husband.
In loving memory of my father, who was a son, husband, and grandfather, and great-grandfather, Nestle Derek Sutton, Sr.
Chief Petty Officer, United States Navy, retired, Vietnam, 1967 to 1968.
In loving memory of my husband, Jaime Enrique Escabi, Specialist 4, Company A, 40th Signal Battalion, U.S. Army. He served from 1968 to 1970. He was my perfect life partner, a fun and loving father, grandfather, kind uncle, brother-in-law, son, and friend. Honey, we miss you so much, but we made it. Welcome home.
Love you, Daddy Dum Dum.
In honor of Arthur D. Thomas, United States Army, in Vietnam, 1965 to 67.
A loving husband of 52 years, a grandfather and a wonderful father.
In honor of my husband, Colonel John Emerson Sims, U.S. Army, Vietnam, 1970 to 1971.
In honor of my dad, Donald Ray Chandler, 1968 to 1971, Vietnam, gone but not forgotten.
On behalf of the family, Timothy Paul Davis, United States Air Force, fly, fight, win.
In loving memory of my husband.
My father, U.S. Air Force, Vietnam, 1967 to 1968, Dennis Dean Burmeister. We love you and miss you.
On behalf of the family of Terry Elmer Fix, U.S. Army, 1967.
In loving memory of my father, Porfirio Rudy Macias.
We miss you.
On behalf of the family of Frederick Allen Hummel, U.S. Navy, 1960.
Our grandfather, Harold Blankenship, U.S. Army, 1969 to 1970.
The family honors the memory of Perry Elliott Flamiak, Vietnam, 67-69, U.S. Army.
In memory of John Percy Young, Marine Corps.
On behalf of the family, Eddie Dale Earls, U.S. Air Force.
On behalf of the family, Howard R. Yateman, Jr., United States Air Force, Vietnam, 1966 to 1967.
For the family of James Beecher Dollins, U.S. Army.
On behalf of the family of Paul Houston Woods, U.S. Army, Vietnam, 1967-1970. Welcome home.
On behalf of the family, David Ray Cox, Air Force, 1969 to 1970.
On behalf of the family of Paul Freeman Lee, United States Navy, Vietnam, 1967.
On behalf of the family of Russell Owen Dalton, Sr., U.S. Army, 1969-1970.
On behalf of loved ones, we honor M.C. Nelson, U.S. Army.
On behalf of the family of Bernard Philip Sierwinski, U.S. Army, 1967-68.
In honor of our caring husband, father, grandfather, sibling, and friend.
Albert F. Crowder, U.S. Army.
He served two terms in Vietnam.
66 to 67 and 68 to 69.
You honored us with your service.
In memory of William Thomas Beale, U.S. Navy.
It's an honor to represent the life and family of William Kelton Carey, USA Army.
On behalf of the family, John Stephen Signorowitz, Jr., U.S. Army.
In memory of my father, grandfather, and husband, David K. Reese, 67 to 68, 61st Heavy Mechanic.
I wish that you could have known my little brother, Michael D. Burns, United States Army.
On behalf of the family of John Bolin Brown, U.S. Navy.
To honor my husband and my dad, Ray Darrow, U.S. Army, 1969 to 1971, Vietnam, 1971. Welcome home, never forget.
It's been 37 years since Dad's passing. Mom and I still think of him. He told me once as a young man he'd served enough for both of us. Today I can only say thank you.
My husband, Dale F. Morin, Spec 5, U.S. Army, Vietnam, 1968 and 1969. I miss him even more with each passing year.
In honor of my husband,
my dad,
Harley L. Rayburn. He was in the Marines for 20 years, 1970 to 1990. He retired as a gunnery sergeant, and we miss him every day.
In memory of John William Owings, United States Marine Corps.
In memory of Thomas E. Fraley, U.S. Marine Corps.
In loving memory of our grandpa,
Vincent Bavera,
United States Air Force.
We love and miss you.
In memory of my dad and Papa, Philip Thomas Eldon, served in Vietnam 1967 to 68 as an MP. We love you and miss you every day. U.S. Army.
In memory of our dad, Bruce Jenkins, U.S. Army, Green Beret, and Thailand Special Forces.
My father,
William Larson,
United States Marine Corps, 1969 to 1970.
Semper Fi.
Hello, I'm here to honor my father, Larry Steins, Army, loving grandfather, loving husband, our number one best friend. We love you forever.
In memory of my brother.
My brother-in-law.
Stanley Sidlowski, Jr., U.S. Army.
On behalf of his family, Richard Witold Parada, Army.
My husband and sweetheart, Larry Allen Dobson, U.S. Army.
In honor of the family of Richard Lee Johnson, U.S. Air Force, served 66 and 67.
My dad, also a husband, father, grandfather, and great-grandfather, U.S. Army, 1965, 1967, Vietnam.
On behalf of the family of Robert Canton Hopp, U.S. Army, served in Vietnam, 1970 and 1972.
In honor of the family of Richard Spencer Davis, Navy.
On behalf of the family of Donald P. Olds, Jr., U.S. Navy, Vietnam, 1966-1968.
In honor of our dad and Peppa, a proud member of the 75th Airborne, a Silver Star, Bronze Star, and Purple Heart recipient, Steve Prince.
The family honors the memory of Donald Harold Hirsch, Vietnam 69-70, U.S. Marine Corps.
On behalf of the family of James Robert Davis, U.S. Air Force, in Vietnam 1968-1969.
On behalf of the family of John J. Valenti, Jr., United States Army, Vietnam 1967-1969.
We're here today to honor our friend, Joseph Tallarico, Staff Sergeant, served in Vietnam, 1969-70. His wife, Chicky, and daughter, Elisa, and grandson, Joe, couldn't be here today. But we're here trying to make up for that. And we miss you, Joe. Welcome home.
Welcome home, Joe.
In honor of Larry Dale Mitchell, U.S. Army, 1968-1970.
On behalf of the family and in memory of John J. Fleming, United States Army, in Vietnam, 67-68.
On behalf of the family of Bill O'Toole, United States Army, Vietnam, 1969-1970.
On behalf of the family of James David Kesselring, United States Army, hurrah.
On behalf of the family, Carol Paul Patterson, United States Army, Vietnam, 65-66.
On behalf of the family of Daniel Allen Ingalls, U.S. Army.
It's an honor to represent the family of Glenn Patrick Baluroso, USA Marine Corps.
In honor of our father, Herbert W. Wilkes, Jr., United States Army.
In memory of Lee F. Ledet, U.S. Marine Corps.
My brother and best friend, Gordon B. Porterfield, Vietnam 65-66, survived Idring Valley, Air Mobile, U.S. Army.
My daddy.
In honor of W.C. Pepper, Vietnam 1965-68, U.S. Air Force.
On behalf of the family of Philip Wayman Holdaway, U.S. Army, Vietnam 67-1968.
In honor of my dad, Joseph H. Dussault, loving father, husband, grandfather, retired U.S. Army.
Miss you, Dad.
In honor of my father
and father-in-law,
Larry Albert Bowers, U.S. Marine Corps, Semper Fi.
Semper Fi.
On behalf of my mom and myself, my father and my hero, Larry Hobart Byerly, U.S. Marine Corps, Purple Heart recipient, you've been gone 41 years, and I miss you every day, and I could not be more proud to be your daughter.
On behalf of the family, Jack O. Kuhlman, U.S. Navy.
We honor our father, known to his friends as Gubach, the Polish prince to anyone with a handle, United States Marine Corps Sergeant David Joseph Penzinski, Vietnam 1962-1968, Lyndon B. Johnson Presidential Citation recipient, and Purple Heart recipient, Semper Fi.
Semper Fi, Dad.
In honor of my husband, Michael Lewis Schrock, Vietnam, U.S. Army, 67 to 69, Silver Star, Purple Heart.
My daddy, Willie Ray Hall, United States Army.
Our father, the Honorable Patrick Charles Monahan, Staff Sergeant, Army, Vietnam, 1968 and 69.
He was a father, a brother, a husband, a grandpa, and a great-grandpa.
And our protector. Thank you, Dad. God rest you.
Rest easy, soldier.
In loving memory of my brother, John T. Flynn, Jr.
Uncle Jack served 4 years in the U.S. Navy, including 1969 to 1970 deployment aboard USS Coral Sea, Vietnam Air Wing.
In memory of Lawrence Eugene Kuhn, United States Army.
On behalf of loved ones, we honor Michael Stanley Pakula, U.S. Army.
On behalf of myself, my sister Tamara, our loving dad, Alan Peterson, passed away in 94, Vietnam, 67, 68, U.S. Army, and his wonderful brother who's here today. Thank you.
Thank you. On behalf of his family, Dale Glenn Peterson, Marine Corps.
In honor of our dad, Sergeant E5 Frank E. McGlinchey, loving dad, husband, brother, and pop-pop, served in Vietnam, 1967, 1968, U.S. Army.
My dad served with the 199th Light Infantry Brigade, also joined up with the 25th Infantry when he was in Vietnam, received the Army Commendation Medal. He succumbed to bladder cancer on the original Decoration Day, May 30th, 2020, due to complications from Agent Orange. We miss you, Dad.
We miss you.
It is an honor and a privilege to represent the family of Benjamin Primus, U.S. Marine Corps, 1965.
In honor of Sergeant William Glenn Oldham, my husband of 41 years, a father, a grandfather, and a husband.
And he did 2 tours in Vietnam, 69 through 68 through 69, and then 70 through 71.
Thank you.
On behalf of the family of Robert L. Reeves, U.S. Army, Vietnam, 1969.
On behalf of the family of Samuel Skip Hines III, U.S. Army, served in Vietnam, 1968 to 1969, a hero to his country, welcome home.
On behalf of the family and loved ones of Henry J. Podlasiewski, United States Army, Vietnam, 1968 to 1971.
On behalf of the family, John Edward Callis, Vietnam, 1968 to 1969, U.S. Marine Corps.
On behalf of the family for Craig M. Phillips, 1967-1968, U.S. Army.
On behalf of the family of James Stephen Kelly, U.S. Navy.
On behalf of the family of John Edward Pierce, United States Army, served in Vietnam in 1967-68.
On behalf of the family of James Nicholas Nguyen, U.S. Army, served in Vietnam, 1969-1970.
On behalf of the family of James Robert Pinter, Air Force.
On behalf of the family of Chester A. Hibbert, Jr., U.S. Army, served in Vietnam, 1964.
On behalf of the family of James Edwin Rich Creek, Sr., Army, 1970-1971.
On behalf of the family of Jaroslaw Klimak, U.S. Army.
On behalf of the family of James Henry Rose, U.S. Army, 1968-1969.
In loving memory of my dad, her grandfather, Richard C. Vigas, U.S. Marines, 1968-69, Vietnam.
In memory of William Edward Wisniewski, U.S. Marine Corps.
In honor of my husband, Raymond Charles Wood, husband,
father, grandfather, and great-grandfather.
Enlisted at age 17 to the United States Air Force and served in Vietnam from 1965 to 1968. May you rest in peace, Pop.
The family honors the memory of Jim Langford, Vietnam, 1970-1973, U.S. Army.
On behalf of the family of Victor Pena Nancyancino, United States Army.
On behalf of the family, Marvin Wayne Poser, U.S. Army, 1969 to 1970.
In memory of my husband, Master Gunnery Sergeant Lauren Richard Hodge, United States Marine Corps retired, served in Vietnam in 1965, again in 1968-69, 21 and a half years in the Corps, Semper Fi.
On behalf of the family of Lawrence Leland Larson, U.S. Marine Corps, Vietnam, 1966 to 1967.
Our hero, father, grandfather, loving husband, John J. Beliza, U.S. Army, Vietnam, 1964 to 1966.
On behalf of the family and friends of William Oliver Honeycutt III, U.S. Army, 1970 to 1971.
Our grandfather, Chief Petty Officer Robert Rands, U.S. Navy and proud Seabee.
It's an honor to represent the life of Ricardo R. Sanchez, USA Army.
My husband, Marine Corps Sergeant Alan Sterling, Semper Fi.
Al was a pastor and personal mentor to hundreds who always taught and then modeled finishing well.
In memory of William Dwayne Hunt, U.S. Army, Vietnam.
In loving memory of our father, husband, grandfather, uncle, Master Gunnery Sergeant Paul J. E. Griggs, United States Marine Corps, served in Vietnam 1966 to 67 and 1972 to 73. We miss and love you, Dad.
Gun hold my brain. All the way, 30 years.
In honor of Gary R. Olds, United States Navy.
On behalf of the family of Ronald Lane Hart, U.S. Army.
In memory and honor of our dad, Dennis R. Gosser, U.S. Army.
On behalf of the family of George Gancars, U.S. Marine Corps, served in Vietnam 1960 to 1964.
Loving father,
grandfather,
our great father,
Sergeant Roger W. Brown, United States Army, Vietnam 1968 to 1969. He loved his family, his country, and the Red Sox.
In loving memory of Brian E. Garman, Vietnam 1966-1970, U.S. Army.
My husband, Tom Beck, Navy Seabee, three tours, 64 to 68.
On behalf of the family of Dwayne Eugene Garrett, U.S. Army, Vietnam from 1967 to 1968.
In honor of our brother, David E. Blaney, U.S. Army.
In memory of Raymond Barnett, U.S. Army.
On behalf of the family, John Sandow, U.S. Army.
On behalf of the family of Ross William Steffen, U.S. Army.
In memory of my husband,
my father, a brother, a grandfather, and soon to be great grandfather,
Wayne DeLoss Wines Jr.
He served in the Marine Corps as a corporal. He was in Vietnam from 1967 to 1968.
OH.
IO.
On behalf of the family, in honor
of Richard Frank Rivera, United States Army, serving Vietnam, 1970 to 71, my husband and hero.
Our family honors my brother Rick, who was a decorated hero, and he was my dad's personal hero. Rick gave of himself and helped many of us through life's difficult times when we needed it, and we are all better people because of him.
In memory of our papa, retired Gunnery Sergeant, United States Marine Corps from 1959 to 1979. Henry William Buss, Vietnam, 1968 to 1969. We love you and miss you.
In honor of my dad and my hero, Ronald Lee Brown, 3rd Recon, U.S. Marine Corps, Semper Fi, Dad.
In memory of Caval Edward Wetmore, U.S. Marine Corps.
In memory of my husband, mi amor, of almost 50 years, Salvador Montoya.
Our father
and pop-pop.
He was drafted into the U.S. Army in 1966, served with the 25th Infantry Division, and served in Vietnam from 1967 to 68. We love you and miss you. Your family and your friends in El Paso, Texas. God bless.
On behalf of loved ones, we honor Craig Stanley Saw Miller, U.S. Army.
In loving memory of James Maloney, we honor our brother.
In memory of my father and on behalf of my mother, James William Wood III, U.S. Army, 1971 to 1972.
On behalf of his family, Thomas L. Kelly Jr., U.S. Air Force, Vietnam, 1970, welcome home.
On behalf of his family, Carl Thomas Beilman, Army.
On behalf of the family, Michael Douglas Gottes, Gott as in Gott, U.S. Marine Corps, Semper Fi.
It's an honor and a privilege to represent the family of George Edward Bob III, U.S. Navy, 1967 and 1970.
In honor of my husband, U.S. Army, 67-68, 199th, married over 50 years.
Loving memory of father, father-in-law, grandfather, and great-grandfather, Danny Kinsley.
On behalf of the family of Alan Earl Bach, U.S. Navy, Vietnam, 1970-1974.
In honor, memory of my loving husband, father, grandfather, friend, and
my loving uncle.
You are always on our mind. You will forever be in our hearts. You are missed dearly every day. Rest in peace.
We miss you. Love you, Uncle Sal.
In memory of Gary Pilott, United States Army.
On behalf of our entire family, Thomas William Bierman served in Vietnam, 1968 and 69, U.S. Air Force.
On behalf of the friends and family of Leo Anthony Schaefer Sr., U.S. Navy.
On behalf of the family of Charles Ray Bradfield, U.S. Army, Vietnam, 1968-1969.
On behalf of the family and loved ones of Richard Charles Woodcock, United States Marine Corps, Vietnam, 1967 to 1968.
On behalf of the family of Johnny Owen Anderson, U.S. Army, Vietnam, 1967-1968, 1970 through 1971.
On behalf of the family of Edward D. Santiago, U.S. Army, 1968 to 1969.
On behalf of the family of Dennis G. Deems, U.S. Army, Vietnam, 1970 and 71.
On behalf of the family of William B. Reynolds, Jr., Air Force, 1965 to 1966.
On behalf of the family of
Staff Sergeant Legree Hairston, U.S. Army, Vietnam. Did two tours in Vietnam. You get the years right? 67 and 71.
On behalf of the family of Jeremiah Francis Whittier, U.S. Navy, from 1970 to 1972.
On behalf of the family of Brian Arthur Kolb, United States Army.
On behalf of the family of John Allen Williams, U.S. Navy, from 65 to 1970.
On behalf of the family of Jerry D. Linhart, U.S. Army, served two tours in Vietnam, 1967 to 1969. Welcome home, sir. Thank you for your service.
On behalf of the family of James Grant Bowles, he served in the United States Army and had two terms in Vietnam, which were consecutive, in 1967 to 1969. He brought happiness to many.
On behalf of the family of David Anthony Masson, Vietnam, 72 to 73, U.S. Marine Corps.
In loving memory of my grandfather.
My dad.
William A. Collins.
United States Army, Vietnam, 1968 to 1969, Spec 4, we miss you and love you, Dad.
On behalf of the family of Robert Terry Barbour, served in Vietnam, 1971, U.S. Army. Gone too soon and greatly missed. Welcome home, sir.
My husband.
Mine and Sherry's dad, Specialist 4th Class, U.S. Army, 1965 to 1967, our chief, Obie Franklin, Jr.
On behalf of the family, William Delano Merritt, U.S. Army, Vietnam, 1971.
In memory of our dad,
Alan Strout, U.S. Army.
On behalf of the family of Bradley C. Barnett, Vietnam, 1971 to 75, U.S. Navy.
In memory of my husband, father, grandpa, brother, Frank A. Filosa.
Army, Vietnam, 1969-1970.
The family of James Craig Geiger, U.S. Army, served in Vietnam, 1969-1970.
My daddy.
My husband.
David Beggs, Nanticoke, Pennsylvania, better known as Crockett, United States Marine Corps, 1969-1971.
Semper Fi.
On behalf of the family of Anthony Genovrino, Marine Corps, served in Vietnam, 1969-1971.
In memory of James Ivan Menzdoff, United States Army.
On behalf of our dad, Clarence Bernard Julio Garcia, Sr.
U.S. Army, Vietnam, from 1970 to 71, 101st Airborne Comancheros. We love and miss you, Dad.
United States Army, 9th Infantry Division, my mother's husband for 45 years. Vietnam, 1969 to 70, my father, Stanley Howard Mersand.
Honoring my father.
And my loving brother.
The Reverend John Pershing Ashley, Jr., United States Army, served in Vietnam, 1969 to 1970, loving son, brother, husband, father, grandfather, and uncle.
Today we honor
Morris Dan Wright,
Vietnam, 1971 to 72, a loving husband, father, grandfather, great-grandfather, and my hero.
In memory of our father,
Spec 4, 11B,
George Arthur Zimmer, United States Army.
Miss you, Dad.
Miss you, Dad.
Miss you, Dad.
The family honors Vincenzo Bordonato, U.S. Army, Vietnam, 1969 to 1970.
In loving memory of our brother, and who is also, he, in behalf of his wife and kids and our brother and sister and kids that couldn't be here,
John Bing Cook Jr., Johnny, U.S. Army, and he served in Vietnam 1971 to 1972.
On behalf of the family and in loving memory of Wallace T. Littlewood, U.S. Marine Corps, 1969 to 1971.
Proudly representing the family of Robert Edward Glennon, 1967 to 1970, Vietnam, U.S. Army.
On behalf of the family and friends of John R. Williams, Jr., U.S. Army, Vietnam, 1968 to 1970.
My husband and my father, Robert G. Young, United States Navy, 1966 through 1969. We love you and miss you, and we thank you for your service.
It's my honor to be your daughter, sir.
Honoring Kyle Letterman, U.S. Army, Vietnam, 1971 to 1972. Welcome home and thank you.
Our dad, Florencio Frank Ramirez, served in Vietnam. He was shot 23 times in the stomach, but Agent Orange is what got him later in life last year. So he was a Purple Heart recipient, motorcycle enthusiast, and a legend in our family. We miss you, Dad. We love you, and we hope that you are finally at peace from the war in your mind.
On behalf of the friends and family of Daryl William Bowman, he served from 1964 to 1967 in the U.S. Marine Corps.
On behalf of the family of Ed W. Hennessy, U.S. Navy.
Wiley C. Mingya, in memory, Vietnam service, 1968-71, U.S. Marine Corps.
Of the family of Adrian J. Hatch, Marine Corps.
It's an honor to represent the family of Howard A. Malone, Jr., USA Army.
On behalf of the family of Kenneth Eugene Hadley, U.S. Marine Corps, 1966 to 1969.
On behalf of the family, John Keith Miskimmons, U.S. Army.
In tribute to the life and service of William Alexander Hewitt, military policeman, United States Army, Vietnam, 66-67.
My dad, Walter Lewis Barber, U.S. Army, field medic with the 199th, 1968-69, Mansfield, Ohio.
On behalf of the family of Alan Ray Hancock, U.S. Army.
U.S. Air Force, Vietnam, 62 to 68, Chapter 641 member, founding, co-founder of the National Wall Washing Crew, loving husband, father, father-in-law, and grandfather, my amazing father, Michael G. Nigerian.
On behalf of the family of Donald L. Tucker, U.S. Army.
In honor of our dad, a loving husband, the greatest papa, Michael Patrick Rogers.
U.S. Navy, served in Vietnam, 1965 to 69.
On behalf of the family of Lewis M. Mike Totten, U.S. Army, served in Vietnam, 1970-1971.
In honor of my husband, a loving son, brother, brother-in-law, uncle, and godfather, Richard Allen Reed, Specialist 5, Vietnam, 1969 to 1970. He passed away due to the complications of the effects of Agent Orange in December 2020. We love him and miss him every day. Welcome home, soldier.
Thank you for your service, Richie. We love and miss you.
On behalf of the family, Stephen Jack Hellerstein, United States Air Force, fly, fight, win.
On behalf of his family, William Steve Meineke, Navy.
In behalf of the family of Robert L. Tolman, who served in Vietnam 1972 to 1973.
Sergeant Michael John Voigt, United States Army, Vietnam 68-69, Purple Heart and Bronze Star.
On behalf of the family, Dale Edward Wicker, U.S. Navy, who served from 1964 to 1966.
In loving memory of our father, David William Burt, Sr., U.S. Army, Vietnam, 1970 to 71, 1st Cavalry Division. He was a loving father, husband, pappy, and he was our hero. We love and miss you.
On behalf of the family of Elmer A. Strickland, Army.
In honor of my dad, Joseph E. Darty, Jr., known as Sergeant Doc. He was in the Army 82nd Airborne, was Van Vaughn, 68 to 69, joined the National Guards, retired with over 34 years, a beloved son, brother, and uncle, an amazing husband, father, and grandpa, a true American, and as always, my hero.
My father, Roland James Mitchell, 1st of the 7th, United States Army, 1968 to 1970.
Gary Owens.
In memory of Frank George Makovsky, United States Air Force, fly high.
I'm here to honor the life of my husband.
And my grandpa.
Of 39 years, and the best friend I will ever have, Kevin Bradley Williams, United States Marine Corps.
In memory of my father, loving husband, best friend a man could have, Adrian E. Badger, First Sergeant, United States Army, retired.
Served in Vietnam, two tours, 1968 to 69, and then 1970 to 1971.
Welcome home, Pop.
In loving memory of my husband,
our dad, and also a grandpa,
Neil A. Burke, Vietnam, 68-69.
Missy Pops.
It's an honor and a privilege to represent the family of Teddy Ray Matney, U.S. Army, 1967-68.
On behalf of the family of Dexter Sturgeon, Sr., U.S. Army.
On behalf of the family of Vincent Lee Macy, U.S. Air Force, Vietnam, 1968-1969.
In memory of our hero, Jack Bean, United States Marine Corps, 1967 to 1970, two tours Vietnam. We're so proud you served.
On behalf of the friends and family, Robert Francis Williams, United States Air Force.
In memory of my husband, Rodney D. Higgins, U.S. Army, welcome home, dear.
On behalf of the family and loved ones of Dennis Anthony Skardzinski, United States Marine Corps. With that last name, I suspect that Dennis tortured and was tortured by his Marine Corps drill instructors, but he served honorably in Vietnam, 1968 to 1969.
We are here to honor Sergeant George Henry Stephen Edwards. Army, he served from 1966 to 1969. He did two tours. He's my hero and my husband.
He's my daddy.
My grandpa.
We love and miss you every day.
Edward A. Johnson, Marine Corps, Semper Fi.
In memory of my husband, Ricky L. Carls, U.S. Army, 69 to 71. We love and miss you, Rick.
Brother.
My father, their grandfather, Dale Kibler, U.S. Army retired in Vietnam, 67 to 68 and 70 to 71.
On behalf of the family and friends of John Norman Gross, Jr., U.S. Marine Corps, Vietnam, 1968 to 1969.
In memory
Stephen D. Vineyard, U.S. Army.
In memory of Joseph Robert Butler, U.S. Army.
In loving memory of my husband of 48 years, whom I miss more every day, Otis Houston Edwards, Sr., Army.
My father, also a loving brother, uncle, pop, and friend to all, and a helping hand to all he met.
We love you, and we miss you more every day. God bless you.
On behalf of the family of Larry Charles Ball, U.S. Marine Corps, Vietnam, 1965 to 1966.
The family honors the memory of Jeffrey J. McCray, Vietnam, 1969 to 1970, U.S. Army.
In honor of the family of Patrick Michael Baker, Air Force, Vietnam, 1970 to 1971.
On behalf of the family and in loving memory of Michael F. Sharp, U.S. Army, 1970.
On behalf of the family, we honor you today, Patrick M. Malone, U.S. Army, 1968. Welcome home.
On behalf of the family and friends of Donald Drew Street, U.S. Army, Vietnam, 1968 to 1974, thank you for your service.
On behalf of the family of Stuart W. Ballard, U.S. Army, Vietnam, 1966 to 1967.
On behalf of the family of Richard Charles Watson, U.S. Army, served in Vietnam, 1968 to 1969.
On behalf of the family of Jack R. Arnold, United States Air Force, served in Vietnam from 1968 to 1970.
On behalf of the family of Richard Edward Greaser, served in the United States Army in Vietnam in 1970.
On behalf of the family of Peter David Andres, United States Army, Vietnam, 1967-68.
On behalf of the family of Patrick P. Amell, U.S. Marine Corps, served in Vietnam, 1968-1969. Thank you, sir, for your service. Welcome home. Semper Fi.
On behalf of the family of Malcolm Frank Armstrong, U.S. Marine Corps, served in Vietnam 1960 to 1967, thank you for your service and welcome home.
On behalf of the family of J. Blaze Alaknis, served in Vietnam 1965 to 1966, U.S. Army.
My brother-in-law, Sergeant Major David Joe Hopeditz, U.S. Army retired, Vietnam, 66-67.
On behalf of the family of Willie Frank Anderson, U.S. Navy, served in Vietnam, 68-69. Welcome home.
I'm the loving wife of Donald Edward Yates, Greenwood, Indiana. He volunteered for the U.S. Marine Corps, 66 to 69. He served in Vietnam, 1st Marine Division, 1st Tank Battalion, near Da Nang, Vietnam, to start out. He ended up being 100% that he fought for. And one of his disabilities was being an amputee and on dialysis, and unfortunately he passed on the dialysis machine, January 6, 2011. We almost had 50 years in. We have 4 grown sons, 11 grandchildren, Poppy. I know he's finally happy. He's being respected today, and I thank everyone that did it for him. Thank you.
Proudly representing the family of Larry Emmett Gross, U.S. Navy.
My husband, Glenn Skip Charles Smith, Jr., United States Army.
On behalf of the family of Bernal J. Busing, served the U.S. Army in Vietnam from 1967 to 1968.
In honor of and memory of our dad,
and our family's husband and grandfather, proud U.S. Air Force veteran, Sylvester, better known as Mac McLaughlin Jr.
Served in Vietnam at MACV from 1968 to 1969.
We love and miss you.
On behalf of the family of Floyd Edward Burns Sr., U.S. Army, Vietnam, 1970.
In loving memory of my wonderful husband and best friend, Wayne Talley.
My father and my hero, U.S. Army, 1970 and 71. We love you and miss you.
In memory of my husband, Donald Lee Wilson.
My dad and papa to Bo, Brett, and Brianne.
He served in the U.S. Army from 1967 to 1971.
In memory of Jose Ramon Velez Murillo, loving husband, father, grandfather, and brother, served our country in the U.S. Army 4th Infantry, Vietnam, 1967-68. He died this past February from Agent Orange-related cancers. I carry this picture, our wedding picture, as yesterday was our anniversary. Your family and friends in the U.S. and Puerto Rico love you and miss you.
In loving memory of my husband.
And my dad.
David John Stencil. He was a loving brother, uncle, brother-in-law.
He was a friend, a great
son-in-law.
Son-in-law and great uncle.
Vietnam, 1970 through 1972, the United States Army.
In memory of Thomas S. Cafferty, United States Army, Vietnam, 67 to 70, on behalf of his wife, Linda Cafferty.
Our dad, Dr. Raymond Arthur Hestrus Jr., U.S. Army.
To honor the life and service of Herman David Burris, United States Navy, Vietnam, 61 to 67.
Loving memory, my husband, the father of our two daughters, Robert Edward Box, Lance Corporal, United States Marine Corps, served Vietnam 1967-68. Welcome home, Semper Fi.
My brother and best friend, Alfred Guzelak, U.S. Army, 1969 and 70, 101st Airborne Division.
In honor of my dad, Joseph Casper.
And my husband of 30 years, U.S. Army, 1970 to 1971. We miss you.
In honor of my grandpa, David Nye Hutchinson.
11th Armored Cavalry. U.S. Army, 1968 to 1972.
Dad and Grandpa and much more. Tommy V. Jones, Vietnam, 66 to 68.
We're here for our uncle, Master Chief Ross Harrison Hall, U.S. Navy, a beloved husband, father, grandfather, and brother. Ross was the recipient of the Silver Star Medal. He served three tours in Vietnam starting in 1966. You touched a lot of hearts, Ross. We miss you all.
It is a privilege to honor William Henry Ward Jr., Vietnam 1970 to 1971, United States Army.
In loving memory of my big brother, Brian Edward Bukanowicz, U.S. Marine Corps and Purple Heart recipient.
Brian was our uncle and our hero. He passed away in 1974, so we never had the opportunity to meet him.
Brian, I'm so thankful you're finally getting the recognition that you solely, truly deserved many years ago.
On behalf of the family, John D. Hardin, U.S. Marine Corps, Vietnam,
1967 to 1969.
In memory of Colonel Ernie Adkins, U.S. Army 101st Airborne Division, Vietnam 1970 to 1971, Silver Star, Bronze Star, and Purple Heart recipient. Our brother, he was loved as a son, he was a father, and he was the beloved husband and soulmate of Candy.
On behalf of the family of Keith Taylor Hirsch, U.S. Army.
On behalf of his family, David W. Swarthout, Marine Corps.
To honor Robert Paul McDuffie, Air Force, Vietnam, 1969 to 1970.
It's an honor to represent the family and life of Eusebio Briones Avila, USA Army. Bienvenido a casa.
On behalf of the friends and family of James Alvey McGarity Jr., US Army, 1966 to 1968.
It is my sincere honor to represent the family and friends of Charles Lawrence Burkhart, U.S. Marine Corps, Vietnam service, 1968 to 1969. Thank you, sir, for your service.
On behalf of the family, Paul Menciscus, U.S. Army.
I'm here to represent my husband, Lester E. Brown, Jr., U.S. Army, Sergeant E5, Company D, 1st Battalion, Airborne, 8th Cavalry. He was a Bronze Star recipient, was in Vietnam in 1966 and 67. So the father of two children and four grandchildren, and he did not get to see any of our grandchildren graduate from high school.
My family honors the memory of our big brother, John Charles Robinson, United States Navy, served in Vietnam, 1966-1967. Thank you for your service to our country.
In honor of my father, Donald Martin Freeman, loving husband, father, and grandfather, served the United States Army, Bronze Star recipient, served in Vietnam from 1965 to 67, and again in 1969 through 1972.
In memory of and to honor my beloved husband, proud father, grandfather, and brother, Stephen William Heshey, United States Marine Corps, 1966 to 68. We miss you and love you every day.
In honor of our wonderful, loving father, Master Chief James Shallen, United States Navy, and he served in Vietnam from 1967 to 1970, PBR 571 and 522. Bravo, Zulu Dad. We love you. We got the watch.
On behalf of the family, David Kalemomi Carmen, U.S. Air Force.
Ladies and gentlemen, the final name in our 2021 list of honorees, Alfred Michael Magrum Jr., United States Army.
Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome our bugler, musician first class Ethan Bartley, to play taps. We ask you to stand if you are able for the playing of taps.
Thank you.
Ladies and gentlemen, that concludes our ceremony today. We thank you for joining us. May God bless all of our veterans and the United States of America.